Ladies and gentlemen, our next match is going to present the match in one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Out first, the ace of CWF Mid-Atlantic, Eric Royal!
Scott, what an ovation for the apex of agility, the winner of this year's CWF Rumble, and man, what a matchup here at Battlecade, here at CWF Worldwide. There is an electricity in this room, Cecil Scott.
Yes, there is, and Eric Rowe going for you quick. Oh man, we just got a fight right now. And if you ask me to pick two men that epitomize, you wanted me to match them up and epitomize CWF Mid-Atlantic, it would be these two men.
Look at Everett and Royal duking it out.
Everett will have a decided quickness edge.
Royal is no slouch, though. Oh! Andrew Everett is evasive.
Yeah, Eric Royal's no slouch, but nobody is as fast as Andrew Everett.
Oh! And the ace shuts it down. The ace shut it down.
Man, this thing is starting out hot and heavy.
Eric Royal fresh off a huge victory against Chris Hero last month at Nova Pro Wrestling. Give them a follow at VA Wrestling on Twitter. Andrew Everett gonna fly now. Whoa, through the ropes. Woo, hello. Ah!
Oh, no. We're gonna wipe out fans here.
Maybe a little bit too full in the front row for that. Oh, God! Everett crashes! Man, you can't stop this kid!
Everett is especially fired up right now.
He just told a whole section to move. Oh, God! Oh, Everett into the third row of ringside.
That's what happens when you're a VIP at CWF Mid-Atlantic. You get a wrestler in your lap.
A daredevil! The epitome of aerial perfection. And yes, sir, those VIP ticket holders are getting their money's worth tonight.
Man, I hope they didn't wipe out Papa Hales over there.
I think Papa Hales would stand up and give him a couple of shots.
Probably. We can wipe out Bruce.
Papa Hales may hop in there and do a tope.
God.
Uh-oh, heads up. Everett gonna fly now. Oh! Good Lord, that was the loudest crash so far.
And the apex of agility is showing you why he's earned that name. And Eric Royal has no idea what hit him right now.
Everett has hurled his body at Royal, what, three times now?
And I have to wonder if Andrew Everett is so fired up because Eric Royal has associated himself with Brad Attitude. That's gotta motivate him at this point.
You gotta believe so. Oh, hold on. Everett scaling the top rope. Oh!
I think Everett's about to make short work of this thing. Eric Gorilla's never been taken to like this at the start of the match.
Everett on the ropes, another drop kick. Good Lord, Andrew Everett, cover two. Cecil Scott, you can attest to just being in Eric Gorilla's position here. It takes the wind out of you. You disoriented. Andrew Everett has got a perfect strategy thus far here against Eric Gorilla.
Yeah, you're physically winded, and also mentally you're thinking, what the hell can I do to turn the tide here? Ooh, a good elbow usually does the trick. Eric Gorilla's a lot smarter than people give him credit for.
Yes, he is. Everett. Whoa.
Crap.
Everett avoids the buckle, but he could not avoid the ace.
Eric Royal uses momentum better than anybody. He is so explosive, and just a simple move like that push turns the tide.
These two men, former Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champions. In November at Ultimate Survivor, Royal assisted Lee Valiant of Brad Attitude in attacking Trevor Lee, Chet Sterling, and Andrew Everett. Drew ended up with a beer bottle smashed in his face by Attitude. Everett got some satisfaction winning a fall over Royal back in Matthews. However, oh, heads up!
Pops away!
Oh, the body weight of the ace! However, when Eric Royal demanded a main event opponent for Battlecade, Everett was eager to accept this challenge. Only the second time ever that these two have met one-on-one. First time was years ago when Andrew Everett was still under the mask of the Chiba Kid. Eric Royal won that first matchup.
Right, that match is for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship.
You watch your mouth! We're going through a rebuilding season!
Oh. You don't talk about the Lakers like that in front of Eric Royal.
Fans are talking junk to Royal. Royal took his eye off Everett, though. Not a wise move.
We've seen in the last year, Eric Royal gets really distracted by the ringsiders. He feels like he has to jaw with them. If there's a weakness in his game, and you see it right there, he always has to get the last word.
Cover. Two, only got two.
But he needs to get the last word on Andrew Everett to get himself back in the title contention.
Y'all cheer for Andrew now. Y'all quiet now.
Royal standing tall, man. Just slaps away, does Everett. Royal slaps him right back.
Oh!
Oh, God!
And normally you don't want to get to a slugfest with Eric Royal, but sometimes you just got to take what's there.
Yes, you do. Royal, the ace of CWF Mid-Atlantic. Oh! Royal earned that title 2 years ago tonight against Rick Converse. Hold on. Cover. Two! Royal feels that he is Mr. Battlecade. Listen to these past couple of years. Last year, Royal and the assassin Ray Kandrak defeat two former Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champions, Kamikaze Kid and McCyrus. 2 years ago, Eric Royal defeats Rick Converse in the matchup to determine who would be the ace of CWF Mid-Atlantic. 3 years ago on this night, Eric Royal defeats Trevor Lee in the main event for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship.
Oh my God!
4 years ago tonight, Eric Royal became Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion. Royal has amassed a Battlecade record just about second to none, quite frankly.
Right, very few. I'd say Rick Converse is the only person who has a record somewhat on par with that.
Pretty much, if you look at the history book, right as Converse's record at Battlecade began to decline, oh! That is when Royals began to accelerate.
Right, that's just the nature of competitive sports. As the old guard starts to slow down, the new guard takes over.
Royal is 4-0 at the last four Battlecades. He is amassing a new streak.
You are going to be my boy!
Oh. Andrew Everett has so much pride. He's not going to let somebody trash talk him like that.
Oh. Ow! What a war we are seeing here!
This honestly has been a lot different than what I expected coming in.
I want to say something. Every time Royal gets hit, you see the sweat go flying. It is late in the night on the third week of Battlecade coverage here on Worldwide. As Everett goes to the ropes, those ropes are going to be slippery with sweat. The ring is not in optimum condition like it was earlier in the night. And man, Royal is drilling. He is drilling his former partner. What was that? About 15 unanswered shots. Cover. Two. 2-2-2 after 15 or so unanswered shots from the ace. Only two,
and you talk about the sweat on the ropes. That does take a big chunk of his offense away. We have seen Everett recently does rely on him a little bit more with the strikes, with the kicks. So he does have a few tricks, but...
Oh, God! Face first into the canvas.
But if he cannot fly, he's not going to be there, boy.
Royal. Oh, God! Oh! Royal!
Uncommon strength.
Yes, he is. Royal is just manipulating Everett. Cutler! Two! Only two.
And if you're Royal, you have to feel somewhat unbeatable right now. He beat possibly the top independent wrestler in the nation, Chris Hero.
Right.
Clean as a sheep.
And he has the chance to beat another one right here in Andrew Everett. And if that happens, you gotta think he will have the chance to beat another one in Trevor Lee. However, Trevor Lee still has to get through tonight as the Mid-Atlantic champion. More on that as this broadcast continues. And I want to let everybody know real quick, everyone on CWF Worldwide, wherever you are in the world watching, we are sticking with Battlecade until we have a winner in this main event. If we go past the start of the hour, we're going to keep right on rolling through. We will get this match and we will get the Mid-Atlantic title match in its entirety in this hour. Might be a supersized edition of CWF Worldwide before all is said and done.
Always supersized whenever possible.
Cover.
Not for nothing, you start talking about heavyweight title shots. Eric Royal's got to get past Andrew Everett first. Everett's not ready to go down yet.
Royal, of course, the winner of this year's CWF Rumble. He's got a shot at any championship in the PWI organization of his choice. We could be seeing two men that are looking at how the main event ends later tonight. When Everett won the Rumble, he kind of, hold on, shoulders are down, two. When Everett won the Rumble, he made clear that he would like another match with Trevor Lee, and man, he just ran into the ace, and the ace, like a tank, just ran right through him.
Well, Everett came as close as anybody to beating Trevor Lee in a classic back in June.
Maybe the match of the year.
Right.
And that's the same year where we saw the 105-minute classic. That may have been the match of the year.
And he feels like maybe he's just a piece or two away from doing it. Because Royal just said he's going to do a 450.
Will he try to beat the apex of agility in his own game?
Not a wise move.
No, it was not.
And as Royal, his hubris gets in the way so much, he felt like he had to show off a little bit. This is a huge opening for Everett. This is a good position for him to have Royal in. Maybe not.
That
could have been a lot worse.
Yeah, Everett held on at the last possible second. Stayed alive at the last possible second. Here against the ace.
Man, Royal's in a bad spot up there. If he takes one wrong step.
You heard the gasp of this sold-out crowd at the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium. We thank you for joining us on CWF Worldwide, but we wish you were here, because, man, the energy in this room just traveled like a wave all the way around the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium.
Man, imagine being one of the 350 to 400 people that we have here tonight. And they are alive for what is honestly a classic match, another classic from these two men.
Week 3 of 3 of Battlecade coverage here on CWF Worldwide.
Royal's out on his feet.
Everett starting to work here. I'm going to say it right now. I have been watching Andrew Everett since his earliest days in the sport, since he was literally a child flying all around this ring. This is as good as I have ever seen Andrew Everett in a CWF Mid-Atlantic ring. Everett is on his game tonight. Win, lose, or draw, this is an A-plus performance. If Eric Royal wins, he beat the best Andrew Everett.
Yes, he did. And Andrew Everett, more than anything, his head is in such a different place than he was at years ago. He knows where to put it all together. And Royal knows he's in a fight, win, lose, or draw.
Everett became the rising Generation League champion, what, about 8 years ago tonight at Battlecade. We talked a couple of weeks back about what that rising Generation League championship means to kick off a career. Everett has enjoyed an amazing career traveling the globe. 8 years ago tonight, he became rising Generation League champion. Tonight, tonight he looks to perhaps assert himself as the ace.
He keeps trying to trade Royal. Man, another step up Izugiri.
Caught him. Royal got caught there.
Man, he is loopy. Gonna go for it again, maybe. He telegraphed.
Drilled him right in the back of the head.
What a patronizing ass Eric Royal has turned into.
Yeah, but the confidence is returning to the ace.
Springboard Space Jam, and that might do it.
He turned Everett inside out. Cover, gotta get the shoulders down. There it is. Two. Oh, man.
He uncorked something special there. Honestly, I think if he had gotten that cover a little quicker, he might have had it.
Yes, he did. Oh, man. We are seeing a classic here. Could be the tackle. Could be the sick kick. As we saw last week in the Ultra J title match, could be something we've never seen here on the big night.
Right, you pull out the special tricks at Battlecade. And this is a match you will only see at the Sportatorium, and the ace is about to submit his name. No, Everett, too quick.
Well, that was great on the part of Royal to stop his momentum like that. Amazing athleticism from both these athletes. Everett trying to chop him down.
That was three kicks in a row right to the head.
Everett. Oh! He took his face off.
15 minutes have expired. 5 minutes remaining.
Man, oh, man. That might
be. That was a close one.
Clotheslined him into oblivion there.
These two amazing professional wrestlers, two of the finest that CWF Mid-Atlantic has ever produced here on our biggest night of the year.
And Everett again saving himself on that top rope.
Everett will be more at home on the top rope, typically. Has he taken too much punishment? We may be about to find out.
But he's always going to go for that big shot. He's always going to fly.
Everett has his back to him, though. I was about to say, Everett had his back to him. Oh, a crash.
Standing shooting star.
Got him. Roll through. Everett's going back up.
Moonsault.
Got him.
Beautiful.
Two.
Royal barely got that right shoulder up.
It was a little more than a flinch.
Just enough. And Everett just unloaded everything there.
Man.
Does the kid have anything left?
I'm just about out of breath watching this incredible match.
And a night where we're guaranteed a Trevor Lee championship match, these two might be stealing the show.
Everett going back to the top. What will be too many risks?
The one that doesn't work will be too many risks, but in the meantime, he has to go for it. He's good at this more than anybody.
Maybe the best in the world. Oh, he ate pavement on that shooting star.
That was one too many.
Oh, cradle shoulders are down. Two.
Oh, dice on the Oklahoma roll.
Look at Eric Royal's face. Eric Royal thought that was going to be all.
Incredulous here at this rookie referee.
Referee Josh Bear has really been put into the line of fire here tonight at Battlecade. Hell of a way to make your Battlecade debut, kid. Oh, man. Royal.
Time up.
Royal is cooking. Royal is cooking on Andrew Everett here.
Look at your daddy over there. Look at your little nieces over there. Sorry, Andrew Everett ain't coming out tonight.
Oh, God.
God, he may not be coming home.
That was the loudest shot of the night so far. I'm talking about all 3 weeks of Battlecade. That was the loudest shout of the night so far.
Oh, Everett, what does it take to keep this kid down?
I cannot believe that Everett is still alive.
Man, oh man, oh man, what a match.
Another matchup here that is flirting dangerously close with the allotted time limit. Created some space, they have created some distance.
They used the springboard drop kick to great effectiveness earlier. What the? What the?
Everett is hanging from the rafters!
Oh, holy shit! Oh. Power bomb the hell out of him!
Royal just powerbombed Everett out of the ceiling! Royal just powerbombed Everett out of the ceiling!
He just sent him straight into Irvin with that tackle!
Oh my God! Cover! And the ace has won an instant classic! Eric Royal wins an instant classic!
And the planet of the ace keeps turning here at Barricade!
23 seconds. You have by pinfall, Mr. Battlecade, Eric Royal.
That was 3. That was like 9.
I told you, man. I told you. Yay, yay!
The Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium is the number one venue for live pro wrestling in all of the Carolinas. But did you know that you can also rent the Sportatorium for all of your anniversaries, fundraisers, and live pro wrestling birthday parties? Check us out at CWF247.com to find out more about how you can have your event right here at the Sportatorium.
See how I'm coming more like off my hip? You were like... This one's going up on launch here. It's the little things that make you money. It's the little things that make people talk about you. No matter what, it's still gonna hurt.
Yeah!
and around the world, this is the main event of Battle King. It is scheduled for one fall with a firm 30-minute time limit. If the champion does not score a fall in 30 minutes, he forfeits the championship. If the champion is disqualified, he forfeits the championship, and the challenger cannot be disqualified under any circumstance. Introducing first the challenger from places Trevor Lee has never been. He is a former Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champion, the winner of the 2004 CWF Rumble, a former Florida Championship Wrestling Tag Team Champion, Florida Heritage Champion, the winner of the 2014 Johnny Weaver Memorial Cup Tournament, a two-time Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion, the One Star, Brad Attitude! Champion, Mid-Atlantic Television Champion, Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champion, Pro Wrestling International Ultra J Champion, yeah! The winner of the 2013 Johnny Weaver Cup Tournament, yeah! And former PWG World Tag Team Champion, TNA World Tag Team Champion, TNA X-Division Champion of the World, Omega Heavyweight Champion, Battle of Los Angeles Finalists. And he is the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion,
Cecil Scott is Trevor Lee looking at the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship for the last time. Brad Attitude gives a kiss for good luck. And man alive, you want to talk about energy and emotion. It is raining down in the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium right now. This is the main event, and Brad Attitude is already seeking refuge on the outside.
When you were making your introductions, I just wondered to myself, is Brad Attitude going to do exactly that? Is he going to out Trevor Lee, Trevor Lee, in the sense that is he just going to bail and stall for time? Very similar to when Trevor Lee beat Lee Valiant a couple of years ago in that Weaver Cup final.
Right, he extended Valiant.
Right, it wasn't a case of where it was an evenly matched contest for 45 minutes. Trevor Lee befuddled and frustrated Lee Valiant for 45 minutes.
That match really the catalyst for what became the style of Trevor Lee that we know today, those long, drawn-out, no-time-limit classics. And, oh, Attitude! With a nod to the events that I'm not going to say set this in motion, because apparently it was set in motion a long time ago, but Attitude with a nod to...
Apparently it was a lot more personal than we realized.
Attitude will win the Mid-Atlantic Championship right here if Trevor Lee cannot control his temper.
He is baiting him in.
Attitude will win the Mid-Atlantic title if Trevor Lee cannot control his temper. This is a mind game, the likes of which we have never seen in the early moments of this matchup.
And we know goodwill, Trevor Lee is a hothead.
Man, this match is already rated R.
He's gonna kick the hell out of him.
Nothing illegal about that.
Now, if you're Trevor Lee, you gotta go ahead and kick it into high gear. Holy
good God! This thing is already a fight! Trevor Lee is tearing the building down!
Yeah, this thing's confirmed shoot already.
Now, referee Josh Barrett does not have to remove the chair from the ring. It's his discretion. Attitude can use whatever he wants. Brad Attitude basically held the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium hostage back in the month of November until he was granted the right to name the stipulations for this bout.
And if there's ever been a weakness in the game of Trevor Lee, it's this, when he is not able to dictate a pace of a match, dictate the structure, he does suffer at times. And he's got to kick it into a gear he hasn't done in a year.
Right, exactly.
And it's kind of the reverse of the TV title syndrome where you're used to working that hard 10-minute time limit. He's on the opposite end of that.
Correct.
So I'm curious to see if he's going to just kind of absent-mindedly kind of forget where the time limit is and go into his routine, so to speak.
That's what you want,
or if he absent-mindedly picks up that chair, if he absent-mindedly gets a hold of something, if he gets too physical with the official, if he does anything.
It broke. He broke that finger. I heard it pop.
Oh, my God. That was a sickening crunch.
That was disgusting.
You know what? I take that back. That was a sickening snap.
Yeah, that wasn't crunch. It's not a bowl of Raisin Bran.
Oh. Attitude has been blasted in the early moments. But again, the rules favor the challenger. Attitude can survive and leave as champion. Most unorthodox rules we've ever seen. Oh, dear.
He's going to have the most unorthodox bone structure we've ever seen.
This is great strategy from Trevor Lee. Pick Attitude apart. If Attitude can't do much physically, it's going to be real, real tough to stretch the time limit.
Right, and Trevor Lee is right on his game, and he's doing what he's got to do, and he might fly.
Oh, dear. They're clearing out ringside. Trevor Lee could be the field goal kick.
Yeah, set it up. Oh, my God.
I do not recall in any of these Mid-Atlantic title classics, I do not recall Trevor Lee going to the kick and hitting it this early in the matchup. Trevor Lee is clearly prepared to get this thing done in less than 30 minutes.
Yes, he is. And there have been times where he'd be willing to let the guy, you know, try to take the count out after that kick, but he knows that Brad Anderson can't do count it out.
Trevor Lee making space here.
God, just a fly kick to the face. And I'm very impressed he's able to push this pace early on. I actually spoke to a lot of the fans out here earlier, and almost to a man, to a child, to a woman, everyone picked Brad Attitude to win this match.
You're kidding.
Everyone picked Brad Attitude because of the rules and the structure. And I found that very interesting. That I don't find it as a lack of faith in the champion, but more of a lack of faith in the rules.
Has Attitude created a situation that's unwinnable here?
Man, it just manhandled the official.
Well, he can't get disqualified for it. Oh, God! He was swinging for Attitude. He caught the ref. Trevor Lee was swinging for Attitude. He caught the ref. Knee strike.
Kill shot, knee, but no ref. Man alive, he had this thing won.
That's a count of 10, but it's not going to do any good.
And referee, this rookie referee, just gets blasted within the first 10 minutes of the match.
I do not think it's going to be a long matchup here.
No, that's what Attitude wanted. He hasn't wrestled in a year. He doesn't want to wrestle all night.
Wait a minute. Trevor's got the chair. There's no referee.
Yeah, you know who else can't get disqualified right now? Trevor Lee.
Trevor Lee has got the chair, and there's no referee. Oh, this thing may have just taken quite a turn.
Going to set up that kick again.
Oh, Attitude. Seeking refuge in the ring. Attitude, the first shot of offense. Got nothing. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa.
Again. Man, he's going to separate.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
Attitude just swung that chair right at the head of the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion.
And that wasn't a flat pro wrestling chair shot. He swung the side of that chair full blast to the side of the brain of Trevor Lee.
Good Lord. Attitude looking around like he can't believe that worked.
Yeah, now the rules have come back to bite him in the ass.
Oh, now he wants another referee.
I see referee Pierce coming out.
Well, there goes Kevin Pierce. Now Attitude wants a referee. Attitude saying count him out. Count him out won't win you the title.
Does he think it's the same as a DQ?
Perhaps. I guess we would have to make a judgment call in that instance.
He can't exactly make more rules on the fly. The contract's been written.
I mean, a count out is technically a disqualification. Attitude is willing to take it. Attitude may feel like, even with the stipulation and the rules on his side, Attitude may feel like this one's unwinnable.
Maybe there's a loophole. He said if Trevor Lee does not score a fall within 30 minutes.
He did say that.
He is not the champion. There's some legal mumbo jumbo there.
Attitude will win this thing any way he possibly can. Count is at 6. And with this crowd making noise, I don't know if Trevor Lee can hear the count. This could be a big problem here.
Oh, I see. Trevor Lee's busted open.
Oh, my God. Trevor Lee is busted open.
We're at 8. Pierce is as close as he can get so he can hear, but he fell.
He's in.
I do not recall ever seeing a Mid-Atlantic champion busted open before.
Me neither.
In his career.
Interestingly enough, in their last battle in 2014, Brad Attitude was the one that tasted his own blood in that match.
Yeah, we haven't talked a lot about the history. August of last year, Brad Attitude was the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion. He was given the right to handpick the challenger of his choice. He chose Trevor Lee. They went to a 40-minute classic. Attitude did get busted open, but he retained the title. Attitude beat Trevor Lee on that night. Earlier this year, as Trevor Lee was the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion, oh, God! He just fired away at Attitude!
Oh, my God, an Attitude. Oh, my God.
Earlier this year, Trevor Lee was the Mid-Atlantic champion. He was given the chance to pick an opponent. He picked Jesse Atwood, a rookie, an upstart. Brad Attitude said it was a slap in his face. Fast forward to later this year, Brad Attitude gets married in Las Vegas. A story that, quite frankly, I had never heard before. The Attitude told on CWF Worldwide. A friend, a family member comes up to Brad Attitude at his wedding and says, I can't believe that Trevor Lee is at your wedding. The mind games that Attitude's been playing for months, I believe, started right then at that moment. Oh, Attitude, who quite frankly has been places that Trevor Lee has never been, he is now taunting Trevor Lee's father in the crowd. Attitude, who has done a lot of big things in this sport, he said that was the night he snapped. Fast forward to June of this year, Attitude smashes a beer bottle in the face of Trevor Lee. Attitude has been running ever since to get to this night.
And the deeper we get into this match, it's really occurred to me, Brad Attitude was never scared of Trevor Lee. I really don't think it was fear. It was all mind games from the start.
Opportunity.
Right. He was picking his spots. No, he didn't want a one-on-one fight at any point. He knew what he wanted.
He wanted this right here.
Right. He wanted the biggest stage in CWF history, literally, to embarrass Trevor Lee.
Biggest house and biggest gate in the history of this arena. We thank everyone who has joined us live. We thank everyone who's watching from all over the world. I want to point out some more history. 1 year ago tonight, Attitude was the Mid-Atlantic champion in the six-pack challenge. He was pinned by Trevor Lee. Attitude, we did not see him again for 6 months until he smashed the beer bottle in the face of Trevor Lee. And like I said, it's been off and running since then. Attitude made sure that a matchup would happen at the time, place, and circumstance of his choosing. It may pay off here in a big, big way.
And Trevor Lee's starting to get a little defense going here.
Yeah. Oh, Trevor's got the arm!
Triangle choke! It's almost a triangle choke. He's got that arm trapped.
Oh, and a cradle! Cradle! That was great thinking on the part of Brad Attitude.
That's the veteran savvy and a knee right to the head.
Trevor Lee has been compromised. Cover! Cover! Only got two. Trevor Lee has been compromised like we have never seen before. We said that when he defended the title against Cedric Alexander. We said that when he defended the title against Eric Rowe. How many times will we say Trevor Lee has been compromised like we've never seen him before in his title?
Oh, my God.
Before it's the last time. Before it's the end of the title.
Every clock eventually reaches 12. And is Trevor Lee, is he at 3 o'clock or is he at 11:59? And that's always going to be the question.
Attitude is taking his time with the champion. Trevor Lee tasting his own blood, and Attitude just flings Trevor Lee into the chairs. Attitude, will Attitude take a big chance here?
Oh, a sword from the heavyweight Attitude!
Good lord, he crushed it. Good lord, Attitude just went through four rows of seats.
There was a time where Attitude was one of the premier high flyers in this territory. But he's coming off of MCL and ACL surgery. That's incredible.
I want to ask you something, Cecil Scott. Earlier this year, Brad Attitude gets married in Las Vegas. It's the party of the year. Someone, a friend, a family member, a guest, says, man, Trevor Lee is at no way. That's really cool. It's almost an overreaction on Brad's part. Is this valid for Brad Attitude to be so insulted that Trevor Lee is perhaps seen as a bigger star or a bigger name than Brad Attitude? Is this an overreaction?
I think it's possibly an overreaction, but I think it's tied into something a lot deeper that he hasn't talked about. And we may never know what it is, but we talked about that six-pack challenge last year. Brad Attitude goes down with injury to get that ACO. During that time, right, that was the kickoff to the current popularity, so to speak, of CWF Mid-Atlantic. That's when everybody started talking about CWF. Trevor Lee was the poster child. Brad Attitude was nowhere to be found. Brad Attitude was usurped as a name, as a champion.
As the champion.
As the champion, as a cornerstone of this promotion. And we talked about it with other guys that get, I don't want to call it jealousy, but when someone else takes their place and usurps them, it does something to their brain. We saw it with Converse, we saw it with Royal.
Ooh,
where did he get that stick?
I was about to say on the plus side, it looks like, oh dear.
Does hurt a lot, Brad.
I was about to say on, oh, that's classy.
Real classy.
Oh!
And the wrestling Jesus is being crucified right in front of us with that cane.
It looked like the wound has closed up on Trevor Lee's head. I'm trying to get a good look at it.
Yeah, I don't see, it looks like it's clotted up.
Okay. Oh, man.
He may open it back up, though.
Oh,
he caught it.
He can't use it, though. Trevor Lee has got to come barehanded. Woo.
Yes, he may tap him.
He's got the cane, the kendo stick across the face. That makes it illegal.
Pierce gave him the count, though.
Oh, Trevor Lee caught up in the moment. He used that kendo stick to his advantage. And there you see the five count. It is not a no disqualification match for the champion.
I do love the I love the judgment by referee Pierce. He didn't immediately disqualify. He gave him a chance to break it.
He's going to have to here. Stakes are too high in this one.
Great Attitude. Turn it right back around. Drop that throw across the rope.
It looks like the blood, trying to get a good look at him. It does look like the blood on Trevor Lee is beginning to clot. Oh, dear.
We're already halfway through this thing, Brad.
Attitude may open it back up.
I think Attitude, you know he's listening out for the call of the time in this match. He's going to manipulate this clock. And you see, he just rolled out. We just announced 15 minutes. Attitude rolls out to the floor.
Yes, he did. Attitude is keenly aware of how much time, more garbage, literally, from the challenger.
Maybe he and Lee Valiant can share a ring.
Attitude is stalking the champion. Attitude, by the way, is halfway there. Right. He is halfway home.
At this point, he's not living on a prayer. He is firmly in control.
Trevor Lee has been taken out of his match. He has been taken out of his game plan. Trevor Lee has been forced to wrestle Brad Attitude's match. Will it be enough to bring Attitude the Mid-Atlantic Championship?
At this point, I have to say yes. If you ask the fans, they say yes. I mean, everything has gone exactly the way Brad Attitude wanted it.
Suplex into the trash can?
Oh, no.
Trevor Lee has got to be careful using any kind of weapon that Attitude introduces.
Right, even something accidental may come back to fight him.
Whoa!
Brainbuster!
Amazing snap on that brainbuster.
It's one of the most time-tested, deadly moves in wrestling.
Talked about the time in this matchup. We talked about the time a lot tonight. Eric Royal defeating Andrew Everett with less than 2 minutes to spare. The time has been the key all night long here on what will surely be a supersized CWF Worldwide. Oh dear! Oh dear! Oh dear, that's so dangerous! Oh, that's so dangerous! Trevor Lee has got a future! Oh dear! Two! Whoa! Fans in the crowd were calling three. You heard it. We heard it.
We can't underestimate the resolve and the resilience of Trevor Lee, though. We've seen him take too much in this title reign. And yeah, he may run out sooner or later, but we've seen him take so much.
300 plus here in the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium are cheering for Trevor Lee. There's three dorks in front of us chanting for Bad Attitude. That's neither here nor there.
Kids don't know any better.
No, they don't. Oh, man.
Brad Attitude, I don't know. There seems to be some gears turning in Brad Attitude's head right now.
Will he take a big chance here?
Is he going to try to go coast to coast?
Is this necessary? The rules are in his favor.
No, he can just...
Oh, stuck him with it.
It wasn't necessary, but it worked.
Attitude stuck him. Man came down hard on that wrist. Man came down bad on that knee. Attitude stuck him with the coast to coast, but was it an unnecessary chance?
Yeah, he could have just as easily just battered Trevor Lee with that trash can until he passed out. But you see how heavily braced to take those knees on. Those knees have been so damaged in the last 2 years. Unbelievable risk. And normally it'd be great for the champion to roll to the floor like that, but Trevor Lee may not get back in.
Right. The warning was very particular. Trevor Lee does not score a fall in 30 minutes or less. Trevor Lee has got 30 minutes to beat Brad Attitude, point blank.
At this point, he has closer to 10.
Right. We got to be inching up on 20 minutes here in this title fight.
Pierce put a very deliberate count on, though, thankfully.
Seven. This might net Attitude the championship. It would certainly mean Trevor Lee did not score a fall.
Oh, barely.
Oh, dear.
Oh, man, she just screamed it right in that trash can.
The violence we are seeing in this main event.
But that's the thing, it's one-sided violence.
It's true. It's very true. Oh, Trevor Lee has busted back open. That cut is open again. That cut has been busted back open on the head of the Mid-Atlantic champion. He said, bleed for me, did the challenger. Good grief.
Fans trying their best to get Trevor back into it, but he is in waters we have not seen Trevor Lee in a couple of years.
I don't know if that's the same cut or a new one. We'll have to get Trevor Lee checked out at the conclusion of this matchup.
It might be a new one because it looks worse than the first one.
And he's got to survive. 10 minutes. Attitude is two-thirds of the way there. Again, all Attitude has to do is survive.
And I'm honestly borderline shocked that Attitude has not tried to bail out. He's going for the cover.
Two.
I think he wants to prove the point that he is better than Trevor.
He's going
to
ask you if you think it's pride.
Yeah, I think it started out, hey, I'm going to get this belt any way I can. And as we got into the heat of the action here, he wants to beat it, and he's going to do it with his own hold.
He's going to try and win it with the STF. Brad Attitude will attempt to win the Mid-Atlantic Championship with the step-over toehold face lock that Trevor Lee has tapped damn near everybody out with all year long.
And you recall last week with Converse and Anderson, Converse passed out in the hold.
Correct.
The match was over.
Converse was out on his feet and locked in a submission hold. Oh, this is dangerous. This is dangerous.
It's two times. The third one will end.
Oh, Pierce. Referee Kevin Pierce says no. Trevor Lee is staying alive here.
Man, I don't even know what to say about the heart and guts of the champion right now.
Good Lord, what a fight.
He's got that finger, that damaged finger.
Oh, he's got it again. You're right. You're right. Trevor Lee has got the finger again.
Ooh. We've always talked about Trevor Lee. He puts money in the bank early in the match with arm work, and he always comes back to it.
Yes, he does. Ooh.
Oh. right to the Jinigatami, the cross arm breaker.
Attitude is checked. Does Attitude have the guts? Does he want it bad enough? Oh God, just stomped him right in the face. Keen there from Brad Attitude. He escaped one of those pulverizing submission holds.
And Brad Attitude is such a savvy veteran. There's a reason he's been around and so effective as long as he has. You're not going to throw a lot at him that he hasn't seen.
I can never remember a match in CWF history where cameraman Grant Sawyer has had to dodge as much stuff being hurled at his body.
We've stuck this guy in cage to death for crying out loud.
Attitude retreating to the floor again, and once again, time is on his side.
And the symbolic bottle. It's Trevor Lee's title reign dripping out of that bottle just like the beer.
And again, this is as legal as a headlock under the rules that Brad Attitude cultivated for himself.
Oh, oh man!
Fucking God, Brad, I bleed all fucking night!
Oh, my God! The champion says bring it on! Oh, it came through the face! Oh, the bottle crumbles! Oh!
His hand with the glass! His hand got cut up with that glass!
The bottle went into the canvas! And shards of glass stabbing into the flesh of Brad Attitude!
Yeah, he kicked the hand and broke the bottle. And it might be blood coming out of that hand.
Oh! There's glass all over the ring now!
So dangerous.
Oh! Oh!
He cracked himself!
Trevor Lee with the presence of mind!
Ah! Oh man, I thought he was gonna dump into that glass! But the Carolina Caveman is alive!
Oh man!
Buzzsaw kick to the head!
This is bad news for the challenger! Cover! Oh. Attitude survived it!
We're deep in the fourth quarter of this thing, and Trevor Lee has got to hit the shot of a lifetime and put this thing away!
This crowd is rocking for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion!
Attitude, how is he still up right now?
Yeah, Trevor Lee cannot use that chair.
Oh, good God.
The man of the rules. Oh, Trevor Lee's caved in a chair. Trevor Lee just caved in that chair with a kick to Brad Attitude. He destroyed that chair.
Get it out of here.
The velocity of that kick just destroyed a chair. Trevor was one of the VIP chairs.
Yeah, Pierce is trying to tell him, hey, don't do it. Hey, where did that chair come from?
A fan in the crowd gave Trevor Lee another chair. Oh, but it took too long and the blood just flew. The blood of Trevor Lee just flew in the air. The blood of Trevor Lee just flew into the air.
Be careful what you ask for, man.
Just that pause and look at Attitude.
5 minutes remain.
Oh, no.
Here, we are deep in the fourth quarter. On a draw, the challenger becomes the champion. Trevor Lee must win in less than 5 minutes.
Oh, no.
Attitude manipulating the official. And now they're duking it out.
Straight right hands.
Champion and challenger duking it out.
Oh, nice.
Good God, what a war.
Man, what a rolling elbow by the challenger!
Attitude just fired right back at Trevor Lee's face!
Connor! Dropped him in that glass!
Connor, Trevor Lee's hurt! Yeah. Oh, Connor!
But he got the inverted crossbody!
Good Lord, Trevor Lee caught the collision course and everybody's down! As time ticks away, so does the Mid-Atlantic Championship! It slips out of the grasp of Trevor Lee as every second ticks away.
And something I just realized, Trevor spiked himself right on his head. He could not capitalize from that move.
Right, it wasn't the perfect execution like we're used to seeing. Trevor Lee has taken a beating. Trevor Lee has survived a war. Great Attitude, to his credit, has survived a beating as well. But man, we are deep. We are deep in the fourth quarter. We are deep in the ninth inning.
Attitude, he didn't come to run. He came to fight. I can't take that from him.
Oh! Can't believe these two are still throwing shots like that at each other.
Man, he got the shoulder there, but it was enough to hurt him. That glass in the ring is so dangerous.
Referee Kevin Pierce trying to get that glass out of the ring. Hold on here. What's going on here?
Superplex, maybe.
So dangerous.
Get caught up in the lights here.
Oh!
Superplex!
Oh, Attitude Hit Him! Attitude Hit Him! Attitude Hit Him!
Oh, and the psycho high kick.
My God, what a fight! Oh, he caught Pierce!
Oh, God, I just looked at the clock. What horrible break!
Oh, man, there's people screaming in the crowd. STF! Trevor Lee's got the STF, but there's no referee!
He's tapping out! Oh, my God!
Tapping out, but there's no referee. 2 minutes left.
Could you ask for worse timing? And Trevor Lee, it just looked like the life went out of him. He realizes what's going on here.
Your right attitude can run the clock out here.
I have never seen a man look more desperate than Trevor Lee does right now.
Attitude just has to survive for about 100 more seconds.
Man, wait.
The bell will ring whether there's an official or not.
90 seconds remain.
And there's literally nothing Trevor can do.
Crowd is calling for a referee. I think we're out of referees, quite honestly. Oh, Attitude's got the damn chair again. Oh, pump kick.
Yeah, we've only had, oh, Vernon Bulldog.
Vernon Bulldog. Vernon Bulldog, so dangerous. Oh, he dropped Trevor on a chair.
We only had two officials working tonight, and they both got creamed early in this match.
Attitude with the cover. Wait, hold on, hold on, hold on. Oh, it's Robbie Walsh.
It is Robbie Walsh. Man, Attitude cut the hair of Walsh.
It's Robbie Walsh.
In Ultimate Survivor, he cut the hair.
I didn't even know he was here.
Oh, he kicked him low. Kid pulled another one out of his hand.
Good Lord!
Fans,
we thank you so much for joining us on the biggest nightmare in history, Cecil Scott! Oh, my God!
Robbie Walsh remembered absolute justice, and he delivered it in some of his own here in Battlecade. And Trevor Lee is still the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion.
We thank you so much for joining us on CWF Worldwide. We thank you for joining us on the biggest night in the history of CWF. We will see you next week. Woo! The biggest title reign in our sport rolls on.
29 minutes and 27 seconds. We are by pinfall and still CWF.